All right. It's a good day to pray. So would you join me in a quick prayer? Father, we ask your blessing on these people and those they love. We pray, Lord, for George, and thank you for his presence with us. And we also ask, Lord, that you would be with our country. We need it more than ever. And that you would help us, Lord, to walk in ways that are beautiful and healthy in our lives, in our families, in our churches, and in our nation. We ask these things in the name of the one who loves us most, our Lord and Savior Christ. In his name we pray. Amen. Would you please help me to welcome George Wesner.
Traffic lights at the corner of Curlew and 19. The only way you know when to turn is when the person behind you starts honking like crazy. Or it's my turn. I'm delighted to come from New York, where it's about 65 degrees and there's lots of traffic. Down here to Tampa, where it's 65 degrees and there's lots of traffic. But you're all here, and we're going to have a wonderful afternoon. We're going to start with a little medley on a subject that you may be happy to be away from. Snow.
Thank you.
story that I told the last time I was here. That was, Terry, when was it? Is he here?
Yeah.
Terry, when was the last time? You remember? 2000 something, five, six?
Yeah, about 5 years ago.
Okay, it's more than 5 years, I know for sure. I told this story, he said, please tell the story again. So however many years ago, if you were here then, you'll remember that it was 5 years ago and I was 5 pounds thinner then. This is a story about a boy who is very successful, and so he gets a brand new Ferrari car. And his car is so terrific, he goes back to a little farm town where he was born, and he sees Farmer Jones. Farmer Jones is on a scooter. And the boy has his Ferrari car. And Farmer Jones looks in and says, Bill, is that you? He said, yeah, it is. He said, I went to New York. I became a New York stagehand, made a lot of money. I now drive a Ferrari. He said, well, that's pretty terrific. He said, Farmer Jones, would you like to drive it? He said, oh, no, I couldn't possibly drive anything that fast. He said, oh, I see. Well, why don't you at least take a look at the dashboard? So Farmer Jones leaned over, looked at the dashboard, all the way one side and the other, put the scooter back upright, said, terrific, Bill, good luck with it. Don't speed with it. You know it goes fast. He said, oh, Farmer Jones, I'll be fine. The light turned green, and he started off in the Ferrari. And here comes Farmer Jones buying the scooter. He thought, yeah, this guy's going to fight me. So it went a little faster, and the farmer went behind. And next thing you know, the farmer's coming faster. Okay, gives it a little more. Farmer goes behind. More and more until finally there's this race between the farmer and the Ferrari, and now the guy's got the Ferrari going full tilt as fast as it can possibly go. The engine is roaring. He looks in the rearview mirror, and here comes Farmer Jones, closer, 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 until finally he hits him in the bumper, pulls over. There's the farmer laying there with the scooter. Bill gets out. He said, Farmer Jones, I'm so sorry about this. I don't even know how to describe what's happened here. He said, is there anything I can do for you? Bill said, Farmer Jones said to Bill, Bill, for God's sake, unhook my suspender from your side view mirror. Now, Terry tells me I'm supposed to take the organ up, raise on the lift. I haven't been that close to heaven in quite some time. I'd like to play now for you a series of pieces. They are all tunes from movies that have been made in New York City.
Oh.
The first one is a little medley from a musical that was written in 1944, which was then made into a movie called Broadway Melody. And this title song from that is Gotta Dance. And then All the Things You Are, which is probably one of the most beautiful pop songs ever written. You'll all recognize that Jerome Kern piece. Next, we move to Breakfast at Tiffany's. You remember that movie starring Audrey Hepburn, Becky Rooney, and George Pappard and so forth? Two pieces from that, the title song, Breakfast at Tiffany's, and then Moon River, which of course is been voted by the American Film Institute as the fourth most popular song in the world, recorded more than anybody else. 1968, People. You remember Barbara Streisand having the leading role there. That song has been recorded by Aretha Franklin and Dionne Warwick, Steve Lawrence, Nat King Cole, Perry Como, Andy, the guy who lit the theater out there. Andy, what is his name?
Williams,
good. I just want to make sure you're around. People, I love that song. People who need people. They're the luckiest people in the world, you know? We can't make it alone. We really do need people around us. Yeah. And then next, the title song from the movie Godfather, 1972. Now this, my interpretation of this is a little child opening up a music box and hearing that theme. But of course, that theme takes you to sometimes a very unhappy place, because violence and crime never leads
where we think it's going to lead at first, does it? So that's the Godfather music, and then Superman. Of course, this is music written by John Williams. John Williams is a 21 Grammy Award winning composer, director for many years of Boston Pops. He's got more credits to his name than any other film composer in our generation. He's written the music, of course, for so many films, Saving Private Ryan and Home Alone, and you name them, and you know his music. So these are two pieces, the title song from Superman, and then the love theme from Superman, which is Can You Read My Mind? And then finishing with West Side Story. Maria, and if you don't have somebody in your life named Maria, you can substitute three syllables. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. And there may be somebody here that you're with today to whom you can turn with those words. Be careful. Be sure somebody came with that. Now, do you remember all that? Doesn't really matter. If you do, I hope you'll have a good time, but I'm going to go up to on the thing and just keep playing, and I'll just go right through these, and I can't keep coming up and down. You know, it's disconcerting.
Well, the thing is, if I go up too high, you'll see that I have varicose veins.
What do you want?
Microphone is still on. It's echo.
Oh.
That better?
Thank you.
Very generous applause, thank you. Oh, it's cooler down here. I brought my handkerchief somewhere. I think I have to bring that. Okay, let's see. What do I want to do next? Okay. There were two men on a golf course. One of the men had a hearing aid. Now, I'm going to tell this joke about hearing aid because I got hearing aids last year. They lasted 3 weeks, and I threw them in the trash. I thought my neighbor every morning was saying to me, "You look fit." That's not what he was saying. So a delay, yeah, that's something. The guys on the golf course, he said to one man, he says, "Is that a hearing aid you're wearing?" The man said, "Yeah, sure it is." He said, "Not just here, any hearing aid. Look at how it's manufactured." He said, "Ah, that's great. Look at the color of it, match my skin, right? Look at the texture of it, match the texture of my skin, right? Cost me $6,000. I said, "It's terrific. What kind is it?" "Right after two." In 1994, I was privileged to play for the opening of Lion King when it premiered at Radio City Music Hall, and for the Disney Company. And since then, the Lion King has grossed over $900 million. Now, when I was a young boy, you weren't allowed to go to the theater. You certainly weren't allowed to go kind of movie. Well, those times have certainly changed for all of us, thankfully. And now children can get most of the moral guidance in the Disneyland more so than they can in the church. Now think about that for a second. Songs like the Mickey Mouse Club. Well, you want to belong to something. When I was a little kid in Sunday school, we sang, "You bring the one next to you, and I'll bring the one next to me. In all kinds of weather, we'll work together." I guess you're not Baptist. And then another song like "When We Wish Upon a Star." I love that song because we forget about the idea of a star being something that none of us can touch or adequately describe or even fathom in our minds. When the light from a star takes 11 years or so to reach us at the speed of light, I can't figure that out. I don't know who can. And then Beauty and the Beast. Gosh, haven't we been in circumstances where there's a beast in the midst? And you say, well, if that person changed, it would be all right. And that person saying, well, if that person changed, it would be all right. And this song says, just a little change on both parts. And you suddenly imagine that we have much more in common than we have in difference. And then, let's see, there's "Under the Sea" in this little medley. And then after that, "Can You Feel the Love Tonight," Elton John's song. And then we go from that into "Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious." And then, let's see, the last piece in here is "Hi-Ho, Hi-Ho, It's Off to Work We Go." Even if you're retired, you have to have another job to eat at Burns Steakhouse. My goodness. And I sit down there at Burns, and the bill came, I said, "This is a mortgage payment to me." Then we were Donatello. Yeah.
Oh,
and Mr. Donatello said, "George, where have you been?" I said, "Saving up." So I'm going to play a little medley of Porgy and Bess here. And then I'm going to play those Disney songs, and then we're going to be ready for an intermission. And before I do that, I just want to settle because you know where I meet some of these people during the intermission. I'm happy to have some of my great friends here, and I'm not going to mention all of them because I'll leave somebody out. But I do want to tell you an interesting little story about Tampa and Terry and me and how this all happened over the past 30-some years. You may remember that a lot of the concerts that I played with Fred Davis, who passed away 5 years ago. And Fred was serving as a minister of music at a place called Fardale Trinity Church. The pastor there was a man named Dr. John Ralston. I think he may even be here today. Is he here?
Yeah.
Dr. Donovan, good, I'm glad you're here. He said to us, you're going down there, Jeff, you've got to meet this guy, Terry Charles. He's got a big organ, and then you guys can play concert. He said, while you're down there, you better go down and meet this guy named Dr. Dean Lockoff. He's a dentist. But he's an amazing man, and he wants to produce musical shows, and you guys could probably do some concerts. So we did. And we wound up meeting Terry, and we wound up meeting Dr. Dean and his wife Eva. I think they're here today, too. And Dr. Dean said, will you come down to the Curtis Hickson Auditorium in Tampa and produce the Holiday Festival of Holiday Music for us, and direct it, with a Tampa Symphony Orchestra and 300 people in a singing Christmas tree? Like a fool, I said yes. It was the most nerve-wracking thing ever, but it was an exciting evening. We had 15,000 people come. And that steel Christmas tree was what I really wanted to get my hands on. And he said, well, what do we owe you? I said, the tree. So I went back home to my home church, Brookdale Baptist Church, and Dr. Ross Lavo is a minister there. I think he's here today. And he said, let's go for it. And the board said, you want to do what? Yeah, we want to bring an 11-ton Christmas tree here and light it up. And they said, well, let's try it. And it was an amazing project because over 25,000 people's lives were touched with that Christmas tree program that we did in New Jersey. It was pretty common here in the South, but it wasn't very common in New Jersey. But everybody in the church got involved in that project, even a woman named Mrs. Watts, who said she'd take care of the light bulbs in the tree. 4,000 bulbs going through now. She said it'll be great for us people over 65 who need it's good for our arthritis. And it was. And it was good for the old man in the church who said, I'll do insurance. We'll figure out how to insure it. And the man who said, I'm an engineer. We'll figure out how to make it stand. And everybody had a chance. And there was in the foyer, the 2,000 seat auditorium, and I was ready to go. And a couple meets me in the foyer said, what are we doing here? I said, I'm here for the Christmas concert. Why do you think you're here? They said, the policeman was directing traffic and making everybody turn into the parking lot. So who knew? I tell you that story because over the arc of these 30 years, many lives have been touched, many interconnections in so many different places, and particularly here on the West Coast of Florida, where you've always welcomed us as though we were hometown folks. And I'm really grateful for that, and I know Fred was, and I'm just so happy that you're here this afternoon, and I hope you're having a good time. So we're going to do Porky and Bess. Then we're going to do the Disney, and then we're going to have an intermission, and then more to come. Okay, here we go.